It is tonight's top story. Michael Roseboro killed his wife, Jan, 4 years ago Sunday. He was convicted a year later, leaving 4 children with no mother and a father who will never come home.
Well, tonight, for the first time, the family tells us how it is coping with those losses and dealing with the upcoming anniversary of Jan Roseboro's death.
You never get over it. You just never get over it. She was my only sister.
But you do work through it.
My sister's gone, and these children are left. And they're very important to me, so I have to control my feelings and my emotions.
Susie Van Zandt is the Roseboro children's aunt. She is raising them in the family home where she also grew up.
The highs are when they look at you and they say, thank you, I love you. The lows are when they miss mother. I can't be their mother.
The children call Susie their earth mother because they say their real mother is in heaven and they only have memories.
Well, she was like really nice and cared about everybody and never put herself in front of anybody else.
Noah was 9 when it happened.
But Noah sees his father maybe every couple months.
It's a jailhouse visit with the man who took his mother.
I try to forget everything that happened and live like nothing ever happened when I was with him.
I tell him he seems well-adjusted.
Define well-adjusted.
A lot of people may question the decision to keep the children here in the house where their mother was killed, but Susie says this is all the family has ever known, and the children had already lost so much.
The reason was we thought that the familiarity would be, that's one less thing for them to change. The pool could have been a problem.
But it's not. The children tell me the pool did not kill their mother. Their dad did.
I didn't think it would do that to my mom.
Stella has come a long way. She really is, you know, she was the youngest.
Stella was 6 and does not remember much about her mother or that night. But she tells me she wishes her mother was here every day. And it's clear she struggles with her father.
I want to love him a lot more than I do because of what he did. But I can't because I don't want to love him even though he did something bad to my mom. But I still love him a lot.
The children have been in therapy. 16-year-old Rachel was working when we visited. And 23-year-old Sam, who you may remember, defended his father on the witness stand, is working and no longer living at home. Tomorrow night on News 8 at 11, more from the family, including the foundation they're setting up to honor Jan Roseboro's memory.